Hello everyone, Danas here with ActionVFX. In this long-awaited tutorial, I'm going to give you an introduction to Fusion node compositing in DaVinci Resolve. We will be taking a look at the Fusion page inside of DaVinci Resolve, how its node-based compositing works, and in the process, we will be compositing a very simple VFX shot using our ActionVFX freeze node collection. You can download the files that I will be using on the description below. Before we begin, don't forget to hit like and subscribe to this YouTube channel because we have more cool tutorials in the works for you, so you don't want to miss that out. Anyway, without further ado, let's get started. Fusion is a node-based compositing program by Blackmagic Design. You can purchase Fusion as a standalone program or get a version that is built inside of DaVinci Resolve. And that version is the one that we will be using in this tutorial. Okay, so let's start learning about Fusion. Here I have DaVinci Resolve open. Now I want to go to the edit page. And here we have our video editing window, which is extremely familiar if you have done some video editing in other software like Adobe Premiere. So the first thing I want to do is I want to go to File and Project Settings and make sure that the project settings of our video editing is the way that we want. And then after that, we want to import our footage that we will later use in Fusion. So make sure that the media pool window is open, and then we're going to go to File, Import Media, or Control I, and I want to import these two files. Okay, so here I have imported this background plate and also this snow asset that we will composite on top of our plate. If you're trying to import an image sequence like an EXR sequence, you can just select all the sequence files and import them in bulk, and Resolve would automatically read them as one file. Okay, so like I mentioned, for this demonstration, we're just going to do a very simple VFX shot of compositing our snow on top of our plate in Fusion. So there are many ways to get started with doing our visual effects. The easiest way is to just drop in our background plate on our editing timeline here, and then while we are looking at the shot on the timeline, we can immediately switch to the Fusion page, and we have created our VFX composition. So here, for example, we can add a simple blur effects and blur it out. And if we go back to the edit page, our clip will be updated with what we did on the VFX composition. Okay, so let's start fresh again. Let's bring our background plate and then let's go to Fusion. So here we are in Fusion. We have the view of our clip. We can use the middle mouse to drag our monitors around and then hold control and scroll to zoom. And then if we look at our view window here, we can split this viewer into two. So we have view one and view two. And then we can type RGBA to look at red, green, blue, and alpha channel of our footage. And then of course we have our timeline here, and the start and end point is the same as the duration that we have on our editing timeline. And then we have our node window here, of course, where we will place our nodes and do all of our compositing works. And then we have our effects tools here, which is the tools that we will use to do our VFX. And of course, this is not all of them. You can look for more effects tools by holding control and space. And we have the list of effects, and then of course you can type in the effects that you want. And then on the right here we have the inspector tab, which is the settings of the node that we are selecting. And we can also bring out our media pool again if we want to drag in elements into the nodes window. Okay, so now let's actually do our effects. So here, as you may already know, we have what is called nodes. We have the media in node and media out node. And this combined, we have a node graph. So in layer-based compositing like After Effects, we are just layering things on top of each other. Whereas in node-based compositing like Fusion or Nuke, the workflow is more like a series of instructions. For example, we have our first instruction, which is media in one. And this instruction is basically just telling Fusion to import this background plate file. And then we connected it to the second instruction, which is media out, which is exporting the input into something that we can see on our viewer and on our editing. So if you want to add elements and other visual effects, we want to add those nodes or instructions in between the media in and media out. So we put our elements here. For example, like I've shown you earlier, let's say I want to create a simple blur on our plate here. So let's click on this blur, and then we want to connect this in between the media in and media out. We can do that by clicking on the line when it turns blue to disconnect it, and then connect the end of the media in into the input of the blur, and then pull the output of the blur into the media out. Or an easier way to do this is to just select on the media in, and if we click on our blur here, it would automatically create our blur node that is already connected to the media in. Okay, so now on our blur node, we can then increase our blur. And this is what we have. We have instructed Fusion to import our file and then blur our file and then export it out. If we want to disable a node, we can just click here to disable it, or press Ctrl P, or you can just disconnect it by holding Shift and just drag it out. And then if you want to reconnect it again, you want to hold Shift again and put it in between here until the line changes color and release. Okay, so let's delete this. So now I want to show you how to composite elements on top of each other, or here we call that merging. So let's open our media pool again. So here I have imported another asset, which is Magic Fire, from our Magic Fire collection, just for demonstration purposes. You can get this Magic Fire elements as part of our free for subscriber initiatives. More info in the description below. Anyway, let's drag our Magic Fire to our node window, and we have made another media input. So to not make it confusing, let's rename our media node here by pressing F2. Okay, so first, we want to take a look at our Magic Fire before we start compositing. Let's click here to split our viewer into viewer 1 and viewer 2. Currently, we have our viewer 2 here on the right looking at our media out, which is indicated by this dot here that is flashing on the right. If we want to show our output here in the viewport number 1, we can just click on the media output node and press 1. And there we go. So now the two dots are flashing and we have these two identical view on media out. So essentially, pressing 1 on a node would show it on the viewer number 1, and pressing number 2 would show it on the viewer number 2. So something that you could do is you can have like viewer on the right here, number 2, showing the media output, which is the final result of your VFX shot, and then have viewer number 1 to show other nodes that you are working on. For example, we want to look at our Magic Fire here on viewer 1. We can just press 1, and there we go. Or let's disable this by pressing 1 again. We can just throw this into the viewer window. However, for this tutorial, I'm just going to use one viewer just to make things not too complicated. So let's just click on this viewer button again. Okay, so now let's take a look at our Magic Fire on this viewer here. And because this is viewer number 2, let's press 2. And here, as we can see, that our Magic Fire has a pre-multiplied alpha, meaning it has a transparent background, as we can see from the checkerboard here. Or you can just press A to look at our alpha channel, and here we see that we have a very clear representation of our transparency on the alpha channel. So because we already have a transparent background, that means we can just merge our fire directly on top of our background plate without the worry of having any background issue. So to merge, we can just create our merge node here. Or an easier way to just merge one element on top of another is to have the element that you want to put on top, pull the output, and then hook it on the output of the background. Boom, there we go. So now we are merged. And now if we look at our media output, this is what we have. So now our node graph reads, hey, input our plate, and then merge it with the Magic Fire, and then output it. And here, if we double click on our merge node, we have our merge node settings. so we can move things around by clicking here, or scale your elements, rotate it, flip, and then we also have our apply mode, or in After Effects we know this as blending modes, and then we have the operator, which we will talk about in other tutorials. And then of course we have all these other things, and also we have blend, which is just the opacity of our foreground object on top of the background. So each of the settings have this diamond dot on the side, and these are keyframes, as you may have guessed. So if we want to create an animation, for example, let's go to the end here, and we want to click on the keyframe on the center position, and then move back, and let's move this here, and it would automatically create a keyframe, and if we play, it would animate. You can play around with your animation by clicking the spline here, and you can play around with your animation curve, or we can go to keyframes, click zoom to fit. We will have essentially the timeline of all of our nodes. So if we pull down our merge here, we can move our keyframes around to make the animation faster maybe. Or even you can retime your elements, like our magic fire here, we can move it so it only appears for a certain frame and stuff like that. Okay, so on our merge node here, we have these three triangles. This is very simple to understand. The green is the foreground input, which is the stuff on the top, our fire. And then the yellow is the background input, which is the stuff on the background, our background plate. If you accidentally put the wrong input and you just want to switch the foreground and the background, you can press Ctrl T and it would automatically switch the foreground and the background. So the blue input is for masking. And as you've noticed, all of our nodes have blue input in it. That means all of these nodes can be masked. So for example, let's create a polygon node here. And let's draw a simple mask. And then I want to input this to the merge, for example. And there we go. We have masked the foreground, which is the fire, based on the mask that we created on top of the background plate. We can also, of course, input this to the background plate itself. And we have our background plate mask based on the shape that we just created. We can also do this to effects, for example. Let's create another blur here, and let's blur it out, and we want to input our polygon here to the blur, and there we go, the blur now only affects the area that we made. One of the great things of node compositing is it's procedural, so we can easily change things around because every instructions are displayed visually. For example, I can easily duplicate this fire on the comp by creating another merge node. And then on the second merge, I re-input the fire again. And let's move this here. And there we go. One last big thing to keep in mind is the frame size of your Visual Effects comp here doesn't follow the settings of the Resolve project file. But instead, it follows the size setting of the source file that is inputted on the media input. And if you have a merge node, the dimension of the Visual Effects comp will follow the size of the media input that is assigned as the background of the merge. So if we switch the input node here, we can see that our VFX comp dimension has changed to follow the media that is inputted as the background. Okay, so that was a very brief showcase of how node compositing works. So now let's try compositing our snow for real. Okay, so here is a clean slate of our composition. So now let's bring in our snow element. So bring out the media pull window and let's bring in our snow here. There we go. Let's close this and let's rename our node. Now let's take a look at this on our viewer. So this is viewer 2. Let's press 2. And here we have our snow. First, just for fun, let's retime our snow by going to keyframes. And on our snow timeline here, we want to move this just a little bit. There we go. So here we can see that our snow doesn't have a transparent background, because as you can see here, our background is black instead of a checkerboard, like the fire. And if we press A, we have a solid opaque alpha channel. So if we merge our snow here into our plate, and if we look at our media output, we only see the snow covering the plate entirely. So now, our mission is to remove the black background. There are many ways to do that. First, we just use a blending mode. So let's go to merge here, and we want to change our apply mode to screen, and there we go. We have removed the black background. However, what I prefer to do is I want to generate a proper transparency by using one of the color channel, which is red, green, and blue, as the alpha. So I'm sure there are multiple ways to do this, but here is one of them. First, I want to select our snow here, and let's take a look at it on our viewer. And then we want to press Control Space, and we want to search for channel boolean. There we go. So now we have the channel boolean automatically connected to our snow. And then on the channel boolean inspector here, let's change the to alpha from alpha foreground to one of the color channels, either it's red, green, or blue. It's all the same because we have a very white color on the snow, so the red, green, and blue are essentially identical. So just pick one of them. I'm going to pick red. So now if we look at our boolean node on the viewer, see we have created a transparency on the alpha channel based on the brightness of the red channel. So now if we look at the media output, we have our snow. So now I don't want to overcomplicate this. So after the booleans, I want to add a color corrector node, and let's reduce the gain so it follows the brightness of the snow of the environment. And then let's move this up just a little bit. And then of course, let's add our beloved blur. And there we go. We have our snow composition. So now we can go back to our edit tab. So now you can just start editing your clip, maybe add some audio or trim things around. And then after that, if you want to render, you can go to deliver and you want to fill in your render settings and then add to render queue. And then after that, render, and you will have your VFX shot. And that was an introduction to Fusion inside of DaVinci Resolve. From here, you can start creating your VFX shots. We have other Fusion tutorials already on the channel that you can check out. Now you know how to use Fusion, you're gonna need some VFX elements to go along with your project. And you can get those VFX elements anytime at actionvfx.com. At ActionVFX, we provide vast library of high-quality VFX stock footage for your projects. From fire and smoke, energy effects and explosions, and many, many others. You can purchase them directly or sign up to our subscription starting at the low cost of $14.99 a month. This is the most affordable way to access our library, including our subscribers-only free collections, and you can cancel anytime, no contract. Thank you so much for watching. I encourage you to drop a like and let us know in the comment section below what kind of tutorials that you'd like to see next. But most of all, be sure to subscribe. We are aiming for 100,000 subscribers by the end of the year. And also, there are other resources on this channel, such as other VFX tutorials, podcasts, VFX breakdowns, and many others. So be sure to check them out as well. Let us be your number one resource for visual effects. So, see you next time. Bye-bye.